In this lesson, we will discuss how to solve one nonlinear algebraic equation using the fzero function in MATLAB. MATLAB's built-in fzero function is based on Brent's method, which uses a combination of bisection, secant, and inverse quadratic interpolation methods. The general syntax for the fzero function is as follows. Fzero has three arguments, myfunc, x0, and options. The output of the function is assigned to variables x and fx. The first argument, myfunc, is a function or a reference to a function that we want to find the root for. The second argument, x0, is the initial guess for the root or an initial bracketed range for the root. The last argument, options, allows you to set error tolerances and display settings. If you do not include the third argument, default settings will be used. The output of the fzero function is the root estimate x and the value of the function at that root estimate fx. We'll discuss three methods for defining a function. The first method involves using an anonymous function. Let's say we want to find the root for the function x cubed minus 0.3. We can type myfunc equals at x inside parentheses x cubed minus 0.3. This statement creates an anonymous function of a single variable x and sets the function name to be myfunc. Next we type x0 equals 2, which sets the initial guess of the root as 2. We then invoke the fzero function in the statement x, fx in brackets equals fzero with two arguments, myfunc and x0. Since we have omitted the options argument, we will use the default tolerance and display settings. The root estimate will be assigned to x, and the value of the function at the root estimate will be assigned to fx. After executing the statement, we find that x is equal to approximately 0.6694, and the value of the function at x is approximately 0. Most of the time, we are not interested in the value of the function at the root estimate, and will omit fx on the left side. If we type x equals f0, myfunc, x0, we only store the estimate of the root. If you know the root lies between two values of x, you can replace the initial guess with an array containing the limits of possible root values. Set x0 equal to 0, 2 in brackets, and execute x equals f0 myfunc x0 again. We obtain the same value as when we only specified an initial value. If you'd like to see the value of the root estimate and function at every iteration, you can use the optimset command in the following manner. Options equals optimset, open parentheses, the word display in single quotes, comma, the word iter in single quotes, and close parentheses. Then include options as a third argument in the fzero function. Instead of creating an anonymous function, you can type the function directly in the argument list. We set the initial guess of x0 equal to 0, then type x equals f0, with the first argument as at x cubed minus 0.3, and the second argument is x0. As before, we find that the root is approximately 0.6694. You can also calculate the function in a separate m file. Here we create an m file named myfunc.m. The first line of the m file is function value fx, which is the value of the function evaluated at x, equals the name of the m file myfunc and the input argument x in parentheses. Next we type the expression for the function x cubed minus 0.3 and set it equal to value fx. At the command line or in a separate m file, we can calculate the root of myfunc by first setting x0 equal to 2, then typing x equals f0 with the arguments myfunc in single quotes followed by x0.